Auto-reframe should be applied at the end of your editing process, when you're ready to take a single video and alter it to suit multiple aspect ratios. Consider it a finishing tool, best used after you've locked down your cut. To optimize the effect, make sure your video contains a clear subject in the frame. Like all AI tools, the more obvious a tracking point is, the better it works. Auto-reframe in particular likes to look for faces and hands. To apply it to a single clip, you can find it in the effects panel and drag it to the clip in your timeline. The effect will fit the video to the frame by repositioning it along one axis. If the clip doesn't need reframing, nothing will happen. So if you want to use this effect, you'll need to change your sequence settings or adjust scaling in order for the effect to behave as expected. A more common use would be to apply it to an entire sequence. Use the toolbar at the top of your screen to go to Sequence, Auto Reframe Sequence. You can also right-click on a sequence in your project bin to select the effect. When you apply auto-reframe to a sequence, it will spawn a dialog box to give you a little more control. By default, your reframed sequence will be the name of your original sequence with the new aspect ratio added onto the end. In the first field, you can rename the reframed sequence so as to not get it confused with your original edit. I named mine to match the social media platform it's being reframed for, so this one's for my Instagram story. The second field lets you choose the aspect ratio for your sequence to be reframed to. Horizontal 16:9 will produce a traditional horizontal video like what you'd see on YouTube. Horizontal 4:3 is going to be similar to the first option, but it won't be as wide. 4:3 is good for Instagram posts. So is a square 1:1 option. It's just a matter of preference. I'll be choosing the vertical 9:16 option because this one's for my Instagram story. At the bottom, you can choose custom to create your own aspect ratios. The motion presets are referring to the speed of any movement within your clip. Choose slower motion for long pans and faster motion for any quick shifts of vision. You can leave it on default if there are multiple speeds of motion throughout your sequence or if there's not a lot of motion in general. The last decision to make is whether or not to nest your clips, and there's a couple of things to watch out for. Auto reframe works by creating keyframes on the motion parameters of each clip to keep your subject in frame. So, if you have any keyframes on your clips, you'll need to nest or else auto reframe will replace them. However, if you do nest your clips, it'll keep any adjustments you've made, but it'll break any transitions you've applied in between clips. Once you've gone through all the fields, click Create. Auto Reframe will open your new sequence for you. Give it a second to finish analyzing and watch it back to see if the reframe worked as expected. If anything is out of place, you can manually replace any keyframes in the effects control panel to get the sequence looking exactly the way you want. Feel free to reach out to us on Twitter @AdobeCare with any questions you have about the new feature. We'll be happy to help. Talk soon!